Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel. Our topic is cell and its organelles. Introductory portion of this cell has been released in a separate video. I will provide the link in this video. Please go through it. The parts of the cells. Cell is a very important basic functional unit, and the parts involved in it are, we would have known it, mitochondria, centrioles, microtubules, Golgi complex, lysosomes, ribosomes, nucleus, nucleolus, and endoplasmic reticulum. Let us see about cell membrane. It has proteins, carbohydrates, and fats. The protein part are globular protein, glycoprotein, integral protein, channel protein, alpha helix protein, cholesterol, phospholipid bilayer, glycolipids, carbohydrates, hydrophobic tails. And the scientists who worked in this told about the fluid mosaic model in 1972 by Jonathan Singer and Darth Nicholson. Let us see about the transport of the molecules across the cell membrane for small ions and individual molecules. The cell membrane is permeable to the solutes through channel proteins and transport proteins. There may be channels for separate channels for sodium, potassium, or chloride, and there may be sodium potassium ATPase pumps which cause influx or efflux of ions. Let us see about the transport for larger molecules. There are three types. One is phagocytosis. They ingest the larger solutes, and pinocytosis. They ingest the larger liquid droplets. And next is receptor mediated endocytosis, which digests the materials through the receptors. Let us see the other mechanisms. One is exocytosis, which occurs in the Golgi apparatus, that expels the stored neurotransmitters or proteins out of the cell through a process called exocytosis. The cells actually communicate between themselves. How they communicate is called cell communication or signal transduction. Let us see how this happens. First, there will be a signaling cell which communicates with the other cell. Through a signaling molecule, it binds to the next cell transmembrane receptor, and there will be a effector substance in the inside the cell. This is called the first messenger. The first signaling is called the first messenger, and that causes generation of second messengers. They carry the message inside the cells, and that may activate the target proteins, leading to cellular responses such as transcription, survival, metabolic activities, or cell death. Let us see the first organelle, endoplasmic reticulum. And there are two types. One is a rough endoplasmic reticulum, other one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The first scientist who expressed this is K.R. Porter in the year 1948. He told about the portions of the endoplasmic reticulum, cisternae, vesicles, and tubules. Rough endoplasmic reticulum contains ribosomes involved in protein synthesis, and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is concerned with the lipid synthesis or the enzymes or detoxification. The next organelle is Golgi complex. It is for the three-dimensional structure of the proteins, or the functional activity of the proteins is in the hands of Golgi complex. So it is named after the scientist who discovered it, called Camillo Golgi, in the year 1898, and it is concerned with the transport and store of proteins, lipids, and digestive enzymes. All the enzymes are produced in the inactive stage only in the Golgi apparatus. The next organ is mitochondria, which is the powerhouse of the cell. It contains foldings called cristae and particles called Fernandes-Moran particles. It is named in the year, previously it was named as bioplast by Kolliker and Altman. After that, by Benda, scientist named it as mitochondria. It is permeable to most of the molecules. All the enzymatic activities of Krebs cycle occur in the mitochondria except succinate dehydrogenase. It has some amount of DNA. So it has some activities which it can do itself, called semi-autonomous organelle. And the unique feature is it is inherited from the female parent only, and it is also used to trace the human origin by testing the mitochondria. The next organelle is ribosomes. It has a larger subunit and a smaller subunit, and it is concerned with the transcription. George Pellaid represented about ribosomes in the year 1953. And the units, larger or smaller subunits, are named and numbered based on the Theodor Swedberg units, in the who was the scientist who discovered the size of the ribosomes in the year 1929. In the prokaryotes, they have 70S ribosomes with the 3 RNA molecules. 30S and 50S are the subunits, and they have the RNA 16S ribosomal RNA and 23S and 5S ribosomal RNA. Humans or the plants, the eukaryotes have 80S ribosomes. They have 4 RNA molecules, 2 subunits. One is a smaller subunit, 40S, and a larger subunit called 60S. And these further subunits are 18S RNA in the smaller subunit, 28S, 5.8S, and 5S rRNA in the 60S subunits. The next organ is lysosomes. It is nothing but the digestive enzymes are stored in the lysosomes, and it is named after the scientist Christian D. Dewey. He called it as suicidal bags. It is concerned with autophagy, that is, after aging the cell digests itself, or autolysis. It is also concerned with phagocytosis and exocytosis. The next organelles are cytoskeleton, which gives shape and structure to the cells. The first is microvilli. It is concerned with absorption in the small intestine. The next is intermediary filaments. They protect the cells from the mechanical stress. And the next is microtubules, which are concerned with the cell division. They contain centrioles. They are short triplets of microtubules. The next organelle is very, very important organelle, that is nucleus. So it is concerned, it is the largest organelle. It has nuclear membrane, a nucleolus, chromatin. It controls the genetic information, concerned with the mitosis and meiosis, and DNA duplication occurs because of the nucleus. Let us see the macromolecular assemblies in the cell. One is a chromosome. The DNA winds itself to a protein sets called histone proteins, which form the chromatin. And the chromatins wound around itself called chromatin fiber, which causes a macromolecular assembly called chromosome, which is made of chromatids. The next macromolecular assembly is proteins. They are formed from peptides, that is a connection of amino acids. They form alpha helix. They combine to form beta pleated sheets, which combine to form ribbon models, and they combine to form the regulatory or functional proteins, such as actin, myosin, microfilaments. The next macromolecular assembly is cell membrane. The fatty acids combine to form a lipid bilayer with the proteins, and they assemble to form the cell membrane. So these are the macromolecular assemblies. So we have seen about the cells, cell organelles, and macromolecular assemblies. I hope it's a short nutshell information of these things. I think it will be useful for you. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. If you like this video, kindly press the like button. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel for further updates. Thank you.